action, please. And playback.
Doing music videos is really fun, but it's also really challenging to think of new things.
Hey, Vanessa, Taylor.
Typically, a director will write the treatment, and they'll write the video, and then they'll direct it too. But Declan worked so well with my storyline for Mean that I knew he'd work well with my storyline for ours.
Morning. Here we are in the Taylor Swift Hours video.
Yeah, that's good.
The performance is all going to happen in the story, so we're not going to cut away to any performance spaces, which is very unconventional, and this was Taylor's idea, to do it in character, and so that's what we're going to do.
Elevator buttons and morning air. Stranger silence makes me want to take the stairs.
This single is doing something that we've never done before. I put this song on a bonus album. The fans found it, played it over and over again, and requested it, and now it's my single, and it's getting its own music video.
All right, we're rolling.
That's what I love so much about my fans is they always let the best song win.
Don't you worry your pretty little mind. People throw rocks at things that shine.
There are so many different choices that you have to make when you're making a music video. And if it turns out to be something you're proud of, then it's a real accomplishment.
But this love is ours.
This is my second time working with Declan as a director, and he directed another video of mine called Mean. I wrote the treatment for the video, which is the storyline and the details of it, and he directed it, so it was very collaborative.
And go for it. Boom, done.
I had a very definitive idea as to what I wanted this video to be. So I just wrote it and I sent it to him, and he called and was like, I'm so excited, let's do it.
Or anyone can put it past you to come out.
You know
what? That's terrific.
When Taylor says, I've got an idea, you listen to what she's going to say. And so I did, and it was a great idea, and I loved it. I'm like, this is great. And having had that same relationship before and collaborated with her on the past video, I knew it was going to be a good experience.
And look up, Taylor.
I trust her, she trusts me, and that's just the perfect balance.
Declan is so calm and laid back as a director, and he's funny to have on set, and he makes everyone feel appreciated, and he makes everyone feel like he's grateful that they're there, all the extras, all the stand-ins, and I really appreciate that when there's a positive energy on set, when the director makes everyone feel happy to be there.
Thank you all so much for coming. You look great.
Morning.
I'm good. I'm excited. The story of this video is the ups and downs of this girl's day in the life.
Action.
This girl hates her job. It's boring, and every single day, she doesn't even know what she's really doing at this job.
Taylor works in an office building. We see her enter the office building, go up in the elevator. She sings as she goes up. She goes into her desk and sings at her desk.
Elevator buttons and morning air.
Excellent.
It's not like it's awful, but it's just boredom. It's just everyday monotony. There happens to be a lot of subtle comedy to that. It's kind of a day in the life of what she goes through on a daily basis. But this day is different because this day she has something to look forward to.
Every story's been told. It's the way you tell it. It's the story of this romance between a guy and a girl. But it's not a conventional romance in the fact that you don't really see a lot of the guy. I think because of the way we're going to shoot it, because of the acting, the style in which we're going to do it, I think it's going to set this apart.
I wanted it to be real life. I just love the contrast of, you see somebody light up when they're with the person that they love, whereas they can be living in tones of gray when they're not.
Okay, I'm ready, here we go.
The guy who we cast to play my love interest is a guy named Zach Guilford. He was someone that I had in mind because he's really endearing in all the roles that he plays.
I asked for a right-handed rake because I'm right-handed.
This is a left-handed rake.
And they thought they were funny and they got me a left-handed rake. I've never done a music video before, so it's a little different. I'm not actually talking and saying words like I normally would. Just pretending there's music playing in the background and trying to make it come to life.
A lot of times you work with people and there's conflicts or difficulty. He's been completely on board with what we've been doing.
Well, I was pretending to throw leaves at Swift. When you see the video and you see how in love I look, you're gonna understand how good of an actor I am. Because really, it was that guy.
He's a really nice, pleasant guy. It's been a real dream. Him and Taylor got on like a house on fire, which always helps when they're meant to be a couple. And so there wasn't that much acting involved.
Taylor's super sweet and nice. They have a lot of respect for her as an artist, and so it was cool that she wanted me to be involved in something. It wasn't too hard of a sell. It was a pretty easy acceptance.
I've seen him in movies and in shows that he's been in, and I was just always really impressed by when he's on screen. He always brings heart to it, and that's what I wanted in this character.
From what I understand, you were like the first choice.
You know, I read that in there, but I thought it was just when they showed it to me and they wrote that in. It was flattering. It got me.
The locations for this job has been very diverse and very interesting. We're shooting in an office building, an airport, a house, and on a bus.
Here we are in the office, and as you can see, it is a truly grim place to work, and that is exactly what we want from this. We've taken out any personality. It will all be very sterile and very boring.
Everything has been specifically chosen to make this office the worst office you've ever been to. The bus is a genuine Nashville transit bus they let us use.
All right, we're rolling.
We were surprised that we actually got to use Nashville International Airport because it's a functioning airport, it's very busy.
We've controlled the traffic. I mean, the Nashville Airport has been so amazing. We have like all these people walking through, they're all our extras. It's crazy to have this big of an airport just let us shoot here.
We found this house, which is for sale, and it would fit the bill for Taylor, like a starter home. And so this house, surrounded by these colorful trees, was a real find.
We had some adorable neighborhood people outside of the house that we were shooting at, and they were singing.
The water's rough, but this love is ours.
And it was so sweet, and I went and said hi to him after we were finished.
Maybe if you guys start singing that song again, somebody might show up.
And look, and there's Taylor right now, stopping for the locals. They've been out there singing.
There were lots of hugs given, so that was a really cool highlight.
Everything has clicked. All the pieces have lined up perfectly, and I'm super psyched. It's been a great experience.
This is how you take on the world. This is what it looks like. I call this corporate not chic. These are the shoes that I come into the office with, and I change shoes at my desk because I don't want to be uncomfortable. Nothing says I don't care about my job like wearing these. I told Declan, I really don't want this to be something where it looks like it's trying to be a cute music video, as far as like fashion sense.
Taylor was really clear about wanting it to look very real. This character is working hard all day at a job that's not necessarily the most glamorous job. And then that dictated the hair, which was, you know.
Very natural, like every day, like how anybody would wear it to work.
She wanted a no makeup look for this, so it was pretty simple and clean.
She will be toned down like you've never seen her before. It's gonna be dowdy, frumpy, not attractive.
I wanted my hair to be like straight, kind of, bangs kind of. I didn't want it to be anything fashionable or anything you would aspire to.
And then we got to turn it around a little bit in the B-roll footage. The B-roll footage is of her in these loving scenes with the male lead. There's a little pop of color and it's fall and she's got the hat and, you know, it's more cozy and warm feeling. We were laughing earlier because even though she's a little frumpier looking in the business look, still in the monitor she looks stunningly gorgeous.
We were trying to make her a little bit more like off, but it's really hard.
to go make some videos of like home movies and cute things that I'm gonna be reminiscing back on while I'm in my awful work day.
We are shooting Taylor and Zach's home movies, showing the lighter side of life.
Get ready, just smile and pose.
We're going to try to create an 8mm home movie effect, which is a kind of 60s camera.
I think maybe we've grown an appreciation for that look. There's a crispness and a history to it. It's not perfect, but it's still kind of cool.
To create the home movie effect, we started to film Taylor and Zach doing these various actions together, like making their home movies. But we realized quite quickly that it was actually better to give them the camera.
It was my first music video shoot. I didn't realize I was going to get to do so much camera work. It's kind of fun. We're just messing around. Running around in the yard.
They have actually shot most of the stuff themselves. We just walked away, gave them the camera, and they filmed each other like a real couple would film each other. That's created a much more genuine, less professional look, which is what we were going for the whole time.
I've never really, like, got to do that before.
Never done it either.
I'm gonna be extra annoying on this one.
It's very rare for me to actually not look. They're filming right now and I'm not even in there. I get to go to dinner early, I'm going to leave Taylor here and she can film the rest of the video.
Okay, giving everybody a 30 second warning, getting ready to roll. 30 second warning, thank you.
We need all these extras to fill all these locations. The airport, the bus. The house, and so what we did, we cast a very wide net all over Nashville and the surrounding areas, and we had about 200 people come in. Then I pick who I like the look of, and then I send them to Taylor, and then she says for which role, which person she would like to play.
Here we are in the office. We have a weird, eclectic bunch of people who work in this office, and I cast these people to look as peculiar as I could find them.
I think they look terrific. I thought there was someone listening to what I was saying.
We have two actors who are absolutely perfect in this first scene. I walk in and the security guard behind the desk is just sitting there staring a hole into his desk. Oh, you look so sad. And then there's a janitor who's got the most amazing smile. And I fist pound on the way in and a high five on the way out. It's like he's my one friend there.
Lovely. We're having little funny little beats. That are going to go on. She has a scene with a guy who we say is the boss's son, and he's very annoying, and he comes at her with staplers. And then there's the guys who are behind her, who are the nerds, and they're playing each other on video games, and she turns around. She just can't believe it. Then she does a scene in the lunchroom where there's a man in there drinking water. And she's there, and she goes to get some water, and she's waiting, and he just drinks more water, and he turns around. He's like, so what?
Great job.
We're in the lunchroom scene. What's going to go on here is Taylor is eating lunch while doing some paperwork, and there's some of the gossips from the office are gossiping about her. The day just goes from bad to worse for Taylor.
Look at the guy to your right. Do you like Taylor?
We've had a lot of fun with a lot of these things.
The inspiration for this video comes from a lot of different times that I've tried to do things other than music.
That's awesome.
And, you know, if you get kind of funneled into a job that isn't what you love doing, you end up like this a lot.
My personal life, I've worked in some very, very dreary offices, so I can relate to this perfectly. I worked in an office for the government in England, and what I had to do was measure inches, column inches of adverts the government took out in all the regional papers in England, and even that makes me fall asleep even saying that. And I actually did that for a job, and it was the most mundane job. I'm kind of recreating my life for Taylor. She's got a great sense of things, and I think the story will be able to, lots of people will be able to relate. It's a very, very common tale. You hate your job, whether it's in an office or in a field.
Whether that's taking classes in school that you're not passionate about or taking summer jobs that absolutely are nothing like what you want to do with your life.
Or wherever it might be, we all feel some days like that.
It's that feeling that makes people want to escape on the weekend. It's that feeling that makes people rush home to see their family and hug their kids because that's what they live for.
Buttons in morning air.
This is a song that I wrote about, somebody that I was like in love with, and I just didn't see why everybody else had to weigh in on their opinions on it.
And ladies, you're gossiping.
And the verdict comes from those with nothing else to do.
The fact of the matter is, when you have a relationship, it's only between two people. And this song is really about that, and about keeping it between two people and not letting anybody else's opinions matter.
Perfect. And there it is.
So don't you worry your pretty little mind. People throw rocks at things that shine, and life makes love look hard.
The chorus says a lot of things that I really am proud of, like the line that says people throw rocks at things that shine. The truth of the matter is, happiness isn't a constant. You get fleeting glimpses of it. When the rest of it, you're fighting for those moments. But those moments are what makes it all worth it. My favorite thing about this is that, you know, the fans have kind of put their own meanings to what this song is, and the chorus applies to love in so many different forms, and I think that's what I like the most about this song.
The stakes are high, the water's rough, but this love is ours.
Okay, everyone look at Taylor. Look to your left, Taylor.
I just met Taylor this morning for the first time, and she was just super nice, you know, came in, gave me a hug, said thank you for doing it, and I said thanks for letting me.
It wasn't that bad.
It's worst days at work, right?
It's kind of crazy. I mean, she's kind of a megastar. And, you know, even though I have a little bit of celebrity in my own right, it's still when you meet people like that, it's always like, wow, you're like just this person I see on TV or in the movies or at concerts, and now you're like right here and you're totally a normal person.
A lot of the time the artist is involved, but very little to this degree. You don't want to sing here?
No.
I'm just worried that...
It's just like the story just completes itself.
What normally happens is they send you the song, you write an idea, they say they like the idea, they don't like the idea, or I'd like to change this bit about the idea, but then we're good. But with Taylor, she knows what she's doing. She's got great taste, great sense of style and ability. She creates this idea, I make it happen in concert with her. Do you write on the same poster underneath, or do you write on a different poster?
I think I write underneath it.
Okay.
She writes her own music. She's very involved in what she does. It's not just someone with a voice who's told what to do. She's kind of been, for the most part, guiding her own career and creating it.
I've worked with lots of different artists, and Taylor, I have to say, for being as big an artist and as famous, has been an absolute joy, and for being such a young girl as well. She's really incredibly a decent human being and a real great collaborator, and polite and lovely, which is not the way a lot of other artists are. The story of the video, basically, it's a simple story. Taylor works in an office. Her one ray of light in her boring office job is the fact that she has this boyfriend who happens to be in the military.
We are doing the reuniting scene at the airport. It's, you know, this girl who has just been waiting all year to pick up her boyfriend. He's in the army. It's such an epic, romantic place to have a reuniting. It's going so well so far. It's going really great. I have a good feeling about this one.
First half of the video is very much more locked off cameras, much more static, and much more rigid and stiff and uncomfortable, whereas the second half is much more handheld, much more available light, much more loose and attractive and appealing. I think she'll probably run a little bit. I think, you know, you're still a fella, you know, you're still, yeah, you know, yeah, tough. You can't, you know, exactly. You're glad to see her, but you're not going to be prancing and cross. Yeah. Two very successful days. Taylor seems very happy. I'm very happy. And I think, yeah, everyone had a good time, and I'm really hold out high hopes for this video.
Right now we're in between takes, and we're sitting here waiting for the bus to pull up and Miss Swift to get off the bus and start crossing the street.
You don't realize it till the very last moment of the video that this guy that she's been daydreaming about, who she's in love with, is finally coming home on that day.
Throw my bag to the ground with abandon, and I swing around like it's the 60s.
I'm really thrilled to work with Taylor on such a great video. It's been an honor. Hopefully we'll be at next year's CMAs as well as we were at this year's.